Topton offered to send me their infrared monocular, and I thought, hey, an infrared camera and a monocular, that'd be really cool. And this is what they sent. And it's this thing, which is a bit bigger than I imagined for a monocular. And this thing also has a zoom, but it's a digital zoom, and with a sensor resolution at 256 by 192, there's really not much point in amplifying that because the internal display is already 640 by 480, so you can see all the detail that it's got to offer even at the widest zoom. But one thing I do really like about it is it turns on and is ready to go in about 10 seconds, so pushing the shutter button here and looking inside, warming up, and now it's ready to do infrared. And that's way faster than it takes for this one to turn on, or this one. And this one will also record infrared images and video, which is how I got the images mostly, because filming in there like this is not ideal. So this thing is meant to be used outdoors for bird watching or stalking animals, because in thermal infrared, as long as the environment is a very consistent temperature, anything living just shows up like a light bulb because it's so much warmer than the environment. But if it's a sunny day, the sun will warm up all kinds of stuff in the environment, which means you get all kinds of visual clutter in infrared too, because there'll just be all these warm things, so animals and such don't really stand out that much anymore. But I've really enjoyed taking this along with me on walks, especially at night, seeing where houses leak energy, or some people having heat wire along the eaves. I even spotted one person in our neighborhood that's got a heated driveway. What a waste of energy. It's way cheaper to hire somebody to clear away the snow. And even though it's kind of big, it's way more discreet than walking around with this thing, which looks like something law enforcement would use. And walking around in a park, just kind of looking at distances, the trails leading off into the woods, I can really spot that there's people on it way more than I could just see visually, because a lot of these trails get quite dark in the woods. Whereas with infrared, it just lights things up. And this thing is actually quite telephoto compared to regular infrared cameras. So on the left, we've got a regular infrared camera, on the right with a monocular. And you can see so much more detail in this house here. Of course, if you're close up, that's a handicap because your field of view is very narrow. Now, one thing I find very limiting about this one is it doesn't actually give me any sort of temperature readings, whereas this one does display the temperatures, and so does this one, as well as the phone-based one. And the way these things always scale the colors to the temperature range that's within view, there's no way to tell if something that is red is actually hot or whether it's just the least cold thing within view. And talking to my contact at Topton, they say, well, at a distance it's very difficult to get the temperature accurate because the atmosphere kind of attenuates the infrared. But I'm like, hey, I use this one at like 20, 30, 40 meters away and it gives me a reasonable reading. So just to give me some reading, even one that's not totally accurate, would be a big improvement over having no idea if something is warm or just not cold. The other thing this doesn't do is read high temperatures. This one here on this heater reads 550 degrees Celsius, whereas if I aim the monocular at it, it just saturates because its maximum temperature is 45 degrees Celsius. Because this thing is used to look through like this, I had the idea of what if I could just see the regular light with one eye and the infrared with the other light. But the problem is with this thing, the minimum zoom is 2x, so the scale is all wrong, so I couldn't make that work. So I rigged up a very crude sort of 2x monocular using trial lenses and tried looking through both of those and trying to get that to merge, but I just couldn't make that work. I think just the colors from the infrared are so different from what's visible that my brain can't just see those as one image. But I wish this thing had 0.5x zoom as well, because the display resolution is twice the sensor resolution. You wouldn't really lose any detail with that, and then I could try maybe better about looking infrared and visible light at the same time. That said, this one can actually do that without any tricks because it's got the infrared sensor and the visible light sensor right next to each other, so that it can combine the visible light and the infrared just fine. It also comes with an app, but to connect to it, you need to connect to Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, and location information. Seems kind of much, but it actually uses the Wi-Fi to communicate and the Bluetooth to find it. I don't know why it needs location information. Just pointing at myself, it's not terribly clear because it's focused at infinity, and having a large focal length, it has a rather large aperture on the front. But I just moved it across the room and now it does a much better job of capturing me and a bit of space around me. And I can also snap infrared photos from here.
or start video recording. So if this thing had the ability to near focus, it'd be useful to use kind of for examining things close up, but it can't focus that close. But I bought this, which is a thermal infrared lens, surprisingly expensive for a single element lens like that. And that just happens to fit in here and even get stuck in there. Problem is, now it's even more out of focus because this thing is actually focused very near. So I have to get things quite close to it. There, we see some detail here. Only problem is, this isn't actually temperature detail, it's just the solder joints on here are shiny. So all the detail we're seeing here is actually more a matter of reflecting infrared than temperature changes. The middle of the CPU here is actually a little bit warm, but you can see it's quite diffuse because, of course, temperature spreads rapidly through the material. So you're not going to see a whole lot of detail in actual temperature variations. So there's no need to get that close.
So I wish I could find a lens like that with a much longer focal length. That would be really useful.
And I just crudely taped that thermal infrared lens to the front of this thermal camera. And that's actually a bit more useful because this one's got a much wider field of view. So we get to see much more of this actual circuit board. Again, a slightly warm spot in the middle of the CPU, and then some components here are a tiny bit warm.
Now I'm curious why this thing is so big, and it turns out I can pull this rubber thing off the front and that reveals some screws, so let's have a look inside.
And more screws in here. Well, that just gets it loose. Not sure how to get this out. I ended up taking the tripod mount out and that revealed a couple of screws in here, and now I can pull the camera module out, which is much more solid than I expected. And I just unscrewed this heatsink back here, which doesn't reveal a whole lot, but it doesn't look like this whole thing is full of battery. Looks like quite a lot of free space in there, and it's probably just fat on the front because this camera module is kind of big. And I just unscrewed this heatsink here and the screws in here, and that reveals the actual camera thingy. This has got, oh, that's probably got a CPU on it. And this is the actual sensor here, the infrared chip. And I really can't say much about this lens because, unlike the one I bought, this one is completely opaque to visible light. But with this close-up lens back on here and looking at this, it appears to have a rather large aperture. And with this heater turned on, so I have something hot to look at, looking at this lens now, we can see the image of the heater projected through the lens. Kind of neat. Yeah, it's definitely using the whole opening there that it can project the image on. Nothing I can see just looking at it with my eyes because it's only in infrared. And this thing still appears to be alive looking through it. I'm just not getting an image because I don't have a lens in front of it.
I managed to put it back together, still works, and I have to say it's amazingly solidly built for a consumerish kind of product. But I wish this camera module could be optimized to be perhaps a bit smaller. If you look at this, this is Top Don's lowest priced thermal infrared camera. Same resolution, much wider field of view, so it needs a much smaller lens. And this does a pretty decent job, same 256 by 192 resolution as this one. So if they could get that lens a bit smaller and cheapified somehow, then this could be much more sleek and lower priced because this is relatively expensive, costs more than one of these things, for example. Now, I was hoping that it could do everything that one of these can do, just in a longer focal length, narrow beam kind of way, but it doesn't do the high temperatures, and it doesn't show the actual temperatures, so it's limited that way. But that said, I did just order another lens, a zinc selenide lens of a longer focal length that I might be able to use with this thing eventually, because I think looking down at a circuit board, it could be quite useful. And looking at competing products, they all seem to be a bit bulky on the front too. So I guess it's just the lens technology at the moment. I'm sure this could be optimized to be smaller. And competing products also seem to not display the actual temperatures, which again I find very limiting. But that said, I find this thing very useful in terms of being able to look at things far away, looking at the house, looking at some detail and seeing, okay, not just heat is leaking here, but it's leaking in this corner, that sort of thing. So a very useful and fun sort of thing, and I was getting a bit stressed out putting it back together, making sure I wasn't going to break it, because I do want to keep using this thing. And being this time of year, there is a Black Friday promotion on, so if you use the link here or in the description, you can get a discount on this thing for $400 US. Although, again, still not cheap. If you're very budget conscious like me, this might be the way to go, which is one that plugs into a smartphone. And it's much wider angle, but same resolution, and it works pretty good too.